There's no place to escape to.
This is the last street.
On the left.
Right from your glade.
That's when the cannibalism started.
Stare.
Some people have that Unruh head where they have
head.
They look like Easter Island, that big fucking square, big forehead. It's too much room for thinking.
Exactly. That's the problem. Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome to the last stream. I'm Ben, and Henry is with me. Ow, 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 ow. Can
I
be left alone?
With you. No, this is evidence.
Honestly, it's beginning to aggravate me.
No, I'm sorry.
Marcus, how are you?
I'm good. I got
look at this.
Look at this gigantic Lucozade that I got.
Oh, Jesus my God, Christ. Bro. That is diabetic.
You're
diabetes in a can.
You're going to get kidney stones.
No. This lasts me for like a week. I don't drink all this tonight. What are you, crazy?
Wait a second. Do you just like leave it out on your desk like it's like old time brandy? Like it's a Mad Men advertising agency? A little bit of a drink and then you pour it on the rocks? You're like,
you put it back in the fridge. It actually keeps surprisingly well because of all the glucose in it, you see. Because of all the glucose, the fizz stays in it.
Isn't that nice? We covered a story on Side Stories today where a woman killed her husband with boiling water and sugar, and she candied him. And then he's like, no, I know I'm Laffy Taffy. And
he's
died. He died.
6 days later, he died.
Yeah. It's not bad, so be careful. Or
Don't fight with your wife.
She will notice.
You think that my wife is going to boil a bunch of Lucozade and throw it on my face? Okay,
possible.
I'll fucking watch out for that, boys. I'm pretty certain.
I just see what's going on, guys. I'm looking at the chat. I see Henry's my trans goal. I'm cool with it.
Hell yeah.
That's great.
Why not?
Boner check has not failed because we have not done it. And that's how you know you don't fail the boner checks you don't take.
Absolutely. You always make the shots you don't take.
Absolutely. But
I think
today,
it's like something like that.
Yeah,
right?
I think so. It is a Travis mandate.
Speaking of taking shots, Travis Morningstar, it's his mandate. And I can't, you know what? I'm actually getting excited for this. I'm excited to start punching down because whenever it's a Travis Morningstar mandate, the rage and anger, I was rowing last week. I'm feeling strong. All right.
You were paddling.
Henry,
let me ask you, Henry, we just got back from Denver, and the last time I saw you before I left Denver, you were on your way to the same amusement park that I was going to.
Oh, my God.
Elitch Gardens.
Because we had to leave. It was too hot.
It was bad?
It was too hot. It is one of the most, apparently, I didn't see it until you posted after we went. It's one of the most dangerous parks.
It was like going to Side Stories, the amusement park.
Why do they exist? I don't understand.
We went on two rides.
Why? But I'm just saying, if there's multiple articles about how this park is super dangerous, but like, do we have to
Brock
have dangerous
Wooldridge,
parks?
Brock Wooldridge, you like guys, fans saying hi or not? Yes, we do. Of course, you can say hello.
Sure, you can say hello.
But we like Meow Wolf. We went to the Meow Wolf ride. But this is the thing. They didn't shut it. Nothing was updated. So that we went on the one ride, and it was half broken. It was broken. And then we went on a wooden roller coaster.
No!
And the only way to really describe it was the bone shaker from
Nothing But Trouble.
And it was like... Like,
why do you do that? We just took a plane. Planes are the ultimate ride, aren't they? So you don't have to do that anymore, Henry. You can leave your house.
I know.
Now.
I could drive my car 35 miles over the speed limit. All of a sudden, I'm on a roller coaster.
But it turns, I think something like 20 people died at Elitch Gardens over its 30-year
history.
The ride
you went in, the skateboard ride, people died in.
Which is the
You're
best.
You're trying to cancel my favorite sport, NFL football, and people just get head injuries.
This was the most fun ride I've been on in a long time. It is just a giant skateboard where they put your body on it, and then they spin you around as you go like 75 feet into the air.
It is literally a full-on...
It's a half-pipe.
It's a half-pipe. It's a half-pipe. You go up in the air, and they're like... Because I saw it, because like Natalie's like, I've never heard of this place before. And then I saw you post all those Insta stories of how many people died. And then me and Natalie started looking into it, being like... We never should have went.
No, because I got there and I thought one of my first thoughts was Henry could die here.
I just can't. I couldn't do it.
I'm not allowing it. I'm not allowing it.
I went to the Elitch Gardens website for it is called the Half Pipe, And their copy for the half pipe is, keep your snow gear at home. Leave your image of fresh pow-pow and your definition of big air at the front gate. Elitch Gardens Half Pipe is Colorado's most thrilling snowboard ride around. Guests get to thrash thread and carve their way to the rim of the half pipe while spinning around and around. It's truly epic, dudes and dudettes.
No, all right, well, that dude
was smoking a full pipe when he wrote that.
The thing that scared me is that we went on that wooden coaster first. We noticed the operator was a teenage girl. And then we went to the second ride, and we noticed that the operator of that ride was walking alongside us to the next ride, and then to the third ride. She was just going from ride to ride, operating the rides as people went to them.
Yeah, I think I saw straight up a five-year-old
yes.
running a ride. There was a man, the person who took my ticket, it was a dog. Which I thought was honestly very, that's first cool. of all, I love to see the representation of dog
Absolutely.
Workers out there. It's so nice to see it. But yeah, it was definitely concerning. Because
wow.
I like, I don't have a negative 20 constitution. I am a tough person. The problem
sure.
is you get to a certain point with your physical body. Again, I was telling this before we started streaming. I hurt my fucking foot walking over an uneven curb.
Yeah, why do you think you're a tough person?
I am in shit. And I'm mentally tough.
Yeah.
This whole business takes a fucking mentally tough person.
But I mean, so does The Rock's. But I would say that he is a tough person.
Probably I don't know if he's that tough. I don't think he's that tough.
But the yeah. heat in Denver, which was like 105 degrees, you know how the heat warps people's minds, so you have like a lot of crazy people walking down the street. What happened was people get inside the park, sane people. The heat warped their brain. It was like when somebody turns into a titan within the walls of Attack on Titan. Because you just see a guy go hubbada shubbada hubbada as he's walking to the next ride because his brain has been melted by the sun.
Sounds fun.
But let's get to my first video.
All right, okay. Yeah, I'm ready to be traumatized. Also, double up to Double D. Congrats on opening your tattoo shop.
Hey, cool. Awesome. Congratulations.
That's
yeah,
awesome.
I'm ready to be. All right, guys, everybody... Oh God! All right, let's see what this
a previous mandate of mine, I mentioned a show called Style by Jury, and I erroneously stated that it was a part of England's mean TV ecosystem.
Sure.
But what I got wrong was that it's actually from a mean part of Canada.
Oh.
So this is a Canadian show.
Wow.
And I just mistook it for an English show. But let's watch this. They explain everything, so I don't really like to do anything.
Oh, Almenia, thank you so much for the fans that you made, the custom fans that we took a picture of.
Those
were
right.
Red Rocks. Those were incredible.
Thank you. That's at my house now.
All right. Canadians are mean. We know this.
Well, yeah.
Let's see it.
It only takes 7 seconds to make a first impression.
They look
what would strangers say about you?
Those clothes would terrify any sane, normal man.
I think she
come on.
Sex appeal? Maybe after a couple drinks.
Installed by Jury, the makeup of the candidates come in thinking that they're here for an audition.
Have a seat.
What they don't
know is
that the show's already begun, and that this room has a secret.
Take a look at that mirror right there.
Oh my God.
You see those people back there?
Mm-hmm.
That's our jury.
This is the meanest show.
We've asked them to comment on the kind of first impression that you make.
And some don't take it lying down.
She looks like a happy
Oh,
oh my God. That should give you one kick in the ass.
But not all the candidates fight back.
She was like a victim of abuse or something. Like, she doesn't...
Oh my God. What is this shit? I'm sorry.
A lot of her life, and the way she dresses sort of portrays that. Maybe that's where some of the sadness is coming from.
Then comes
the
offer.
Who the fuck are you?
You're getting the makeover.
Oh my
God. Thank God.
A Canadian
Thank God
makeover.
You traumatized
You're gonna dress
me.
Like me.
Long week.
On our jury today, a
Look at the jury.
Painter,
they're dressed like trash.
A TV news director.
Yep.
A fundraiser. We've asked them.
Cross-eyed.
Fundraiser.
A thief. A grifter.
Jury, are you ready?
Yes, we're ready. Get her. Get her. You look like a bitch.
How dare she be a normal human being?
I think she's off her meds.
You look like a crazy lady.
Oh my God!
Canada.
Bob, what kind of first impression do you think you make?
I think
this is Canada's Billy Bush.
The background is what I try to do.
She looks like she came out of rehab in her pajamas.
She looks like she doesn't.
Oh my God!
Scent on herself.
I think she looks fine.
Like she's aged.
That's what Justin Bieber looks like.
Do you mind if I ask how old you are?
I'm 52.
You're 52. Oh.
She looks exactly like she's had a really hard life.
She looks tired and worn out.
What are some of the things?
You're a fucking bitch. What's wrong with these people?
Really got to get it out.
She looks like she's been an addict for many years.
The substance abuse.
Oh my god, maybe she's been working on like you and the television producer.
She looks horrible, and her life probably feels horrible.
Oh my god. At least in America we keep it superficial. They go deep.
That is our jury. We've asked them to tell us what kind of first impression you make.
Oh my god, I'll jump through this glass window.
She looks like a beggar on the street.
Oh my god. They're not even jokes.
Looks like she can open a can with her teeth.
I think she's hit rock.
Oh my god.
There you go, the jury has spoken. Welcome to
what do you think about that?
Come here.
What if I told you were also, I hate you? I'm actually going to hit you with this tennis racket.
What's the lesson of that shitty, horrible Canadian show?
Well, she finds out that she needs a makeover.
That's the big thing.
She's fine.
You're in
Canada. What do you have to dress like? I would also love to see the makeovers, because I guarantee you the makeovers are fucking horrific.
Terrible.
I am sure of it.
Well, Canadian makeovers, there's a lot of maple syrup that's involved.
I'm sorry.
They're lying to themselves about what's going on in that country over there.
I know.
Yeah, they really
are. They think that they love freedom more than we do.
They definitely don't love freedom.
We invented freedom.
No.
Okay? We invented freedom with a gun and a blanket filled with germs. We came over here and we made freedom happen. We made the Rockies nicer. Yeah, I'll go ahead and say it.
Sure.
We made the Rockies nicer.
Wow, you go there. You really go there.
Because those fluorescent pink clouds that come in because of the pollution.
Because of the freedom?
They're so beautiful. And you wouldn't have that sunset if it wasn't for the grinding factory worker.
I can't wait for interim Professor Henry Zabrowski when you finally get back to FSU and you start teaching the theater school, but you're not teaching them how to act. You're teaching them how to think.
I don't know. Everyone's talking about how sad they are in the chat. There's a lot of people saying, Melanie says, I feel so sad. Everyone's so sad.
Yep, no, this is a Travis band. It is sad. And actually, I'm happy that people feel sad because that was the emotion. That's the proper emotion. So all of us, because I've been watching a lot of psychopath footage on YouTube. None of us are psychopaths. If you feel sad, that's the right emotion on that.
See,
and a little bit of anger.
I do believe that if you want to be on television,
they didn't want to be on television. They were going for a job interview.
No, it was an audition. They said it was specifically that they were going for an audition. That was the whole setup. They didn't know that the audition process had already ended and they were on television.
It's worse than the casting couch.
And as a person who goes in for auditions, you know for a fact, essentially what they did was strip away all of the fake things in an audition, and then just came out and just say, you look like shit. You know what I mean? They decided to go straight to the heart of it. And if you want to sign the devil's bargain of being on television, the devil's bargain, you get punished. I'm not saying that they deserve it.
They just want money. Obviously, they need a little bit of help.
No one's offering me. If they got scooped up by the cops and told to get a makeover, that's fascism. But also, fascism.
Right. Fascism was very fashionable.
What is the the Milgram experiment where they like convince people to shock other people? Is that the one?
The name of it, but yeah, that experiment's amazing.
There is really like that's a lot of what's going on in that show because they even interview the kids of that woman.
Oh my
god! And she's like, yeah, you're right. She looks like a piece of shit.
Jesus! There's enough hardships living life. You don't need a reality show producer ruining your life and day.
Christine on the stream just said, at least the casting couch would be better. You know why the casting couch would be better? It's because at least maybe you get your pussy. Right? Like, in the beginning of it, if you got a good person there, they warm you up.
Of course.
They start pounding you. When you get into the casting audition, like casting couch and shit like that, none of those people are getting eaten out.
I like to watch the female in porn having pleasure.
Is there a casting couch video where...
Hold on, I don't know.
Is there a casting couch video where it is revealed that the people having sex are being watched by people behind one-way mirror?
Because I think that's illegal.
And also, I don't know.
That's money on the table.
I'm 99% certain the casting... They know that is the porn, right?
Yeah.
They know that that's the porn.
Yes, of course.
Whatever makes you squirt.
It's all fake. Yeah, it's all fake.
God damn it, Travis. That is disgusting. All right, let's move on.
Let's move on to...
Speaking of squirt.
Speaking of squirt...
if you guys can't see the preview...
You're in for a treat on this one.
Yeah, let's see this TikTok compilation. This is the only one I'll do.
It's called the Milgram Experiment, according to Riley Richards. It could be a lie, who knows.
Thank you.
So let's see this.
Oh. Hi there. How you doing?
Hey.
I'm hoping you're having a good night. Yes, I'm half naked. If you got a problem with it, that's your problem, not
more,
mine.
More than half naked. He's 3/4 naked.
I love it when women wear those yoga pants.
That's actually very talented.
Yeah, she's like a lion.
What you know about rolling down in the
deep? Oh my god.
Can you see the end of that road? I can't. So will you walk with me? Will you show me the...
Oh my god.
Where the end of that road is? Will you walk with me and show me? Or you sit on the sidelines and just watch?
What was that even about? I don't know, man. This is a nightmare world. Like, this is the scariest world of TikTok of all of them.
I like to take out my teeth before I begin nibbling on your filthy skin. I'm a skin nibbler.
Oh my god! What does it mean?
If any woman needs a real man in their life, here's my phone number. 318-465-2624. I'm looking for a serious relationship.
Get your mouth down there and put a smile on my face.
She should have been on that show. I met a girl, she made me smile, she made me laugh. Oh, hell yeah. Is that a man or a woman? That was a man.
And we're here eating at Olive Garden.
And the retard finally laughed.
There was a tard stalking us.
Oh, my. What is...
I'm a grown baby. Still live with my mommy and suck on your titty now.
Okay, it's quieted down a little bit. So now we're going to get into some top secret Texas shit.
I've been to that party.
Yeah.
All right, that was it. I'm going to send you my picture of my gun.
Come on, all you BBWs. It's Father's Day. What do you got for us?
As you see, I'm drinking milk today. I gotta have some beer.
Oh my god, that's piss. Is that beer or piss? That was piss. Oh god, my god, fucking just stop this.
This is Don McBrenra. I just have to apologize when I was talking about women in their yoga pants. I seem to piss off some women and men.
He learned.
And I'm sorry.
That was the most innocent one we saw.
Everybody, just try and have a nice day.
What? Bye. A moment! Just a moment of self-reflection. Like, he sat.
They redeemed
he
themselves.
Thought about what he did, and he was just like, because also, weirdly, what wasn't that bad. He was
no, he just said he liked women in yoga pants. It's a sentiment that's expressed constantly.
That's why.
Yes.
Is it wrong?
It's just
to
the
say.
Way that he said it, and why the camera wasn't on his face, and does he, there's a series of
he should have taken more ownership of that.
Yes.
Of well, that sentiment.
Coquette Brunette says we wear them because they're comfortable. I don't want to wear proper pants. Sure, but do
I don't care. Yeah, sure.
Do you not also wear them a little bit, especially if you're in good shape? Don't you wear them so that people will see the soft, well-shaped buttocks you have as well? Don't isn't that a part of it too? Is that if you got good meat sure. and then you want to show the meat off,
if there
you're allowed to.
If there was a way for people, yes, I think if there was a way for some women to only be seen by wealthy people, then yes, I think they don't like to be ogled by all is the problem. So then they have to say, then I will be ogled by none. Because the yoga pant, the only thing I'm saying is I've never seen anyone do yoga in them.
You've never been to yoga.
Yeah, you don't go to yoga classes. Yeah, you wouldn't even know.
You have to go to a yoga class to see people do it.
Technically,
cultural appropriation.
Technically, Kissel, it means nothing. It means nothing. If you saw people doing yoga because you don't go to yoga class, technically that's you being a peeping Tom. Because the only way you would have seen it is standing in a parking lot outside of a yoga studio. Just, like Mike Myers, just.
Stretching, huh? Yeah. Stretching, huh? Anyway, I love yoga class.
Same right here. Yeah, Emily Johnson says I wear them to show off my camel toe.
Yeah, dude, I'll tell you something. I saw a toe the other day that was, woo-wee, my God. That was something special
but
there.
Can you do, like, because the thing about, you can like a yoga butt, right? I call it yoga butt, but is it proper, this is for you guys out there with yoga butts, do you like someone to not acknowledge it with verbals, same thing, but can someone go like a...
male gaze. Male gaze. You're not supposed to do that. The thing about being cool is you acknowledge it.
Someone did it to me and I did not enjoy it. They said it verbally and I did not enjoy it.
Who told you? Oh, no, the yoga instructor was making fun of you, but he was
you were a little sensitive, Marcus.
No, he was making sexually inappropriate comments about my ass in front of a room full of people. How am I being sensitive about that?
Well, because he's being positive towards you.
Because I'm just such a fucking, I don't know what you'd term with me. I guess the term is whore. Like, that's what I would be. Where if you told me I had a nice butt in the yoga class, I'd be like, thank you, mister.
Yeah.
Did I get a free class then? Mm,
I have a feeling you won't be getting a lot of free classes.
No, I'm not.
Although for Polish heinies, you've got a 6 out of 10.
Someone says, don't mind looks. I hate leering. They like leering. The hat tip. People
they
say
don't
that
like
the
hat
tip.
Well, they
is
can...
honestly really nice.
They're all
saying it. I'm not saying anything they're saying out loud so that they can't actually be quoted by saying it. But what I'm saying is they're saying it's actually nice. They get a tiny acknowledgement, especially if you're a cowboy or a sheriff.
Sure. I get acknowledged all the time.
All right. Well, let's move on to this. Speaking of sheriffs, I think this might be the sheriff of this town in this next video. I think this might be a classic.
Okay.
A classic video, but I like it a lot. So
this is the classic. I love this video, and thank you for bringing it back to my attention.
Auburn, California. Placer County Animal Control Officer Carl Pritchard is appearing on a local TV show.
This is Pinky. He's a male cat, domestic short hair.
Pritchard is trying to find a new home for this abandoned kitty.
A very loving cat.
Problem is, Pinky doesn't want to go.
Oh my!
I would just let go of the string.
Where's the cat gonna go?
Colleen McGuire, the director of animal control, moves in and tries to cover the ferocious feline with a
box. The laziest. Thank you for the no help whatsoever.
Because he doesn't want to get fucked up.
Grab the damn cat! Grab the cat!
As Pinky fights to break free, Pritchard struggles to keep the animal from injuring
itself. Oh my god, this cat died.
He's gonna get hurt.
But when Pinky goes into a violent spiral up the officer's leg, the cat's safety is no longer his number one priority.
Oh my god!
Yeah.
Grab the cat!
Pinky sinks his claws and teeth into the officer's groin. As Pritchard tries desperately to pry him loose,
I can't believe this cat is kicking this guy's ass.
Of course,
you're an officer of the law.
Horrible scream. I mean, it was painful. That's the tender area on anybody, male or female. I'm sorry, it is.
Yeah, man, I would punch that cat in the head at that point. But you're on camera, too.
It's a cat. Remove the animal from his leg. He's rushed to the hospital with 2 deep puncture wounds.
Oh my god. It is fucking balls!
You know, a little embarrassing, you know, to have to drop your pants and show this nurse where you were bit.
He likes
like what you do when you're arrested.
This cat left a hole in my pants, you know, this big.
But Officer Pritchard wants people to know that this unusual incident is not typical of most pet adoptions.
You gotta look at it, you know, from the animal's point of view. This animal felt threatened, and its basic instinct was to get away.
I don't blame the cat at all.
I don't blame the cat.
I like the cat. The cat kicked the shit out of this guy. Also, imagine him at like a police function where someone's talking about how they killed a bunch of people, and another cop is like, that's when I was shot. He's like, I know. I had a cat fuck me up one time. Like, what? A pussy? What are you? Oh, anyway, I just feel like if you're going to, you could tase that cat. You could tase the cat.
Well, you just got to, unfortunately.
Or just grab the cat. Or
let
the cat go.
Aggressive, what are you going to do with it?
Yeah, a cat that's that aggressive and a cat that's freaking out. You ever tried to grab a cat that's freaking out?
I've grabbed a cat freaking out cat. No, it's not. You just got to grab it and then you hold it kind of away from yourself and they're like, and then you just like tire yourself out, cat.
That's the thing, man. You got to take your size into account. You have much larger hands and you can keep that thing further away from you than most people can.
Yeah, you got to throw a blanket on it and then put cinder blocks on the blanket.
Well, maybe.
That's key. Again, I'm proponing for more nets.
More net guns. A net would have worked there.
You got to be able to catch these, because I also don't know where they got that cat, what that cat was doing by the time they took the sheriff to arrive to arrest this cat.
That was a Heathcliff cat. That cat was hanging out on the wrong side of the cat fence doing wrong cat stuff. But I used to have a cat, Charcoal, and we had a cat, Honey, and Honey was very cute. But I would I would take her to bed with me, and then I would make sure that she never left until I fell asleep.
Oh.
But it was kind of scary for her.
You would make sure she'd never leave.
I would put her under the blankets, and then I would block her from leaving until I fell asleep. Oh, God. And then she would run away. But she did like me. I was like 10.
Well, I once had to punch a dog, but I had to push a dog that jumped at me when I was with Wendy.
That's fine.
It was a big pity. It was like a 100-pound dog, and the guy was unleashed.
Stop.
And the dog came running out as I was going with Winnie. Winnie ran around my legs, so I had to, like, pick her up as this dog was between. But I had to, like, literally grab the side, a very beefy animal, and just, like, push it to the side.
Oh, you went with the push?
Yeah, of course.
I go with the bop.
What do you mean?
Bop it under the nose.
No, yeah. I just pushed it off me like this.
Bop.
I couldn't get nose to it. That's where the teeth are.
What do you do, Marcus, with it? You push or you bop?
I would probably, I don't know if I would have the presence of mind to bop. I think I would probably push, because I would probably freak out just a little bit.
The nose is the balls of the dog. Very sensitive.
Interesting.
You flick actually a dog. Really good. You flick a dog in there, or a clitoris.
It's like with a shark. Oh, yeah, I should say that more to the vet. You always say that to the, it's always important to remember, I know that the dog's nose is like a female clitoris.
I'm saying it's very sensitive.
On a human, it. I mean. A human female
on a human's clitoris. You know what I mean. I have a clitoris. You know what I mean?
Dude,
but you still don't bop. Yeah, you can bop a clitoris, but technically that's fun.
Do dogs have clitori?
I don't know. I stopped asking that question.
I don't know if
so
you should.
So we wouldn't search that up.
I honestly don't know if you should, but honestly, you could probably bop a woman on the clitoris if she's getting out of control.
No, I don't know. What are you? You sound like Sean Connery. He was bad.
Yeah, he was old school.
What do you think, actually, Marcus?
I did find an article on Live Science. Bulldog's large clitoris poses genetic mystery.
Oh, wow. What a mystery it is. Well, speaking of mysteries, what's next, Travis?
How do you say cat in French? It's like chat?
It's like chat.
Chat.
Yeah,
shot.
Shot.
The
don't bop the clit. People are saying don't bop the clit.
Don't bop the clit.
The subject of this next video is from France.
Oh.
Is a guy I found named Maxime Renard. And he's a little bit like a suicidal Mr. Bean. So let's see what kind of videos he puts out.
Right. Shoulder says you can bop the clit.
Oh, we don't have video here.
Oh,
let's
we don't have
again.
The video. Let's give it another go here. Thank you, Fernando. Fernando making sure everything hums along.
Oh, we do. This is the tightest
humming
fucking.
Along.
We've always been the
you can
tightest
hum on a
fucking. You should hum on a clit. Actually, remember that was like a big old one of those tips back in the day, like the hot and the ice.
Yeah,
but you sing a song while you do it.
That's the advice that's given to you unsolicited by a random person at a bar that you're too young to be at, and you're like, I'm so happy I'm here.
But you do it.
That's a grand old flag. That's nice. Maybe on 4th of July. Okay.
There you go. Let's see this video.
Maxime Renard. Lapper.
He is a depressed Mr. Bean.
It's funny sound effects, that's cute.
It's a funny angle for his face. He's so long.
You can't see a lot.
That's all we need to see.
Oh my god, is he gonna kill himself?
Oh yeah, Mr. Bean commits suicide.
That's not good.
Je m'appelle Maxime Renard. Okay.
Okay. What are you doing? Kind of looks like Howard Stern a little bit.
Strangely, you could say that. Yes.
Okay, we have a double shot. So this is very well orchestrated.
And he's just doing this?
He does this a lot to different structures.
Bonjour.
The French are just, do they have more time in the day there?
No, but they have. They sponsor their artists there.
Oh, I see. Oh, okay.
I do like being able to see his face up close. Yeah.
Yep. Oh shit. Okay, now he looks like a fish, doesn't he?
He's really lucky that he didn't fucking really get hurt.
I guess he's not up that high. I've jumped off in rivers higher than that.
You have?
Oh yeah, of course. Yeah. In Menominee, there was a great place, but you had to hit it right. Otherwise, it was shallow on the other side.
Jesus fucking Christ.
He does this with a hot air balloon, too. He climbs up the side of a hot air balloon, and before he does anything, he goes, bonjour.
He's so French. He
and then
so
leads
French.
Into, like, a terrifying act of self-destruction.
Can I ask a true question, and I don't want to be mean here, but why are the French respected?
The French are respected maybe because they are the top culinary? Of the culinary. Music was big in the day.
French?
Art.
What was the French art. Music sound? Was that...
All right,
I'm hard.
Yeah,
you got okay. that.
Serge Gainsbourg. It's just Ford Mustang. We bang. Pow.
Didn't Serge Gainsbourg have sex with his daughter?
Possibly. I'm not going to say yes, but that does sound familiar.
Well, he like put her on the cover of an album when she was like 13.
Oh,
and
my
she
God.
Was like,
all right.
Dirty, dirty man.
Yeah,
I
she was dressed
that.
Like, yeah, she was dressed like Stevie Nicks and she shouldn't have.
No, definitely not. Yeah. I just feel like the French, the like kind of like, oh, we respect it because the language of love and stuff, but then it's full of farts.
Well, they used to rule the world. That's true. They were used to have a very big because what we've learned from the background of the Black Plague time period is that the French were more moneyed and they had more land than the English.
Like, what was the great? I guess they had some good theater and stuff. I just feel like their reputation has been a little bit too grandiose for a little bit too long. And I say it started going downhill when they fell in love with Jerry Lewis. And then
people
from here, what's
international.
I don't know. People still make fun of France for World War II.
They do.
Like, is what they are. That is their reputation.
Okay. Livy Hawker and Chack just said, like, the one thing they did do is that they managed to throw off the yoke of a ruling class and have the people run their government.
Okay.
And now they do have that. They have a way more, like, kind of like a socialist bent government.
Yeah,
I do
but where did they get that idea? America.
Where is it? Where is it? Whoa!
That's where you got that idea, France, you piece of shit.
That's nice. Wow, they're going to love
humor.
That fart humor.
They do. Yeah.
All right, good to know. I've always been a little bit confused.
Let's,
it is a nice
let's
language,
stay
though.
In Europe for this next video. Everyone's watched In the Heights by now, right?
I haven't seen it.
I am such a
oh my God, Travis!
In the Heights.
Travis, you are expanding. He's expanding.
Yes. Yeah.
That was
that's
a song.
A huge song. It is not.
I think
a song.
That's the song.
No, I thought it was. Yeah, In the Heights. In the Heights. Who are you? What are these heights we're in? It's huge, man. I
bodegas
love...
and bridges in the Heights.
In the Heights. Is Lynn Manuel Noriega?
Close.
Miranda.
Very close.
Oh,
I
yes.
don't. Does anyone like that Hamilton musical?
It was among the dullest 3 hours I've ever spent.
It's not accurate either. That. And it's white people rap. Where white people are like, see,
it's,
this is
it's,
oh,
there
I
is no. There are white people who are good at rap. It's Broadway rap.
It is
Broadway
horrendous rap. Music. Okay. The music is so bad and it's dull. It's
it's all like vote. Get on the boat. We got on a boat all the way to here. You got a boat. Like, it's just all the time. It's like, I don't know. No one can.
Well, this documentary, I actually thought maybe this might be a prequel to In the Heights because it's called In the Basement. But I quickly discovered that I don't think this is a prequel to In the Heights. So let's check it out.
In the basement.
In the basement. He looks like it.
He
definitely looks like a man who would be in the basement.
We're gonna get this video out to you ASAP. ASAP. Here we go.
I'm kind of triggered because I have the same body as this man, but that's fine. We just have similar bodies and not
parterre.
We are very similar looking. But
it's like homie.
Homie.
Oh, okay. He is naked and vacuuming. Okay. That is your ass. That is your...
I
wow,
to say,
that is...
This is... I am... What's disgusting about this?
Yeah,
this
well,
is
it's
what
just
I'm
why, is
this
it on,
is a,
why is it
this
on
is
camera?
A man. This is a normal man cleaning his bathroom. Look at his beautiful wife.
With his tongue.
Okay, he's cleaning the toilet
with
his tongue. Are you doing a good job?
Oh,
I see.
Oh, that is the difference.
Yeah, there we go.
Well,
Okay, but even if it is French, it's very nice, I guess.
Honestly, a tongue doesn't get things that
Austria.
Clean.
Austria. Austria.
Not a good place to be in a basement.
Spotless, no slacking, and he's... okay.
Well, you know what I mean? In the
end, if you're the mistress here, you get the best of both worlds. You're not bothered by your husband, and then you just get to hang out, and the bathroom's getting clean.
I like that when I say something.
What is that exciting house?
Wowie, wowie, wow. Oh, it just takes all kind, man.
Little pig boy.
This is it. Cool. I absolutely.
Oh, see, she adores it. Her love slave. He worships me.
Honestly, you know, when it comes down to sometimes you want to ask.
There we go.
She's pissing.
Looks like George the Animal Steel.
It does?
Yeah. She's pissing. Or Johnson.
Yeah. Okay, she's. I want to say that's just piss.
But if. If the seat's dirty, that's on her.
All right, here he comes.
Oh, my God. This is straight-up porn.
Yes.
Jesus.
Yes, thank God.
Can we even show this? Can we even show this?
Finally.
Of course we can.
I just am so excited for this.
Oh, my God. Yes. I am so...
Wow.
His ass is weird butt. I don't even identify that as a butt.
His butt is bigger than yours.
Wow.
Yes, his butt is bigger than that. I think he's a bigger guy.
Meet the Creeper. It's okay to crink shame this.
I'm not. Yeah, it's not.
It's fine though. I do get it. No, I understand. Everyone's free to do whatever they like. We're not allowed. We're allowed to.
It's just not even the best version of.
Wait a second. Was that up his ass?
No, that was
it's my cock. It's my scrotum. My slave's body belongs to me. All right. Well, you do. Good work.
Well, good for him. I'm actually happy for them. I think that it's a loving relationship. I think where they live is a little drab, a little bit sad. Maybe some wall hanging.
You know what it looks like?
In the heights.
In the heights.
In the basement.
Who are you? What is on your balls?
If the two people performing those things were not so unbelievably what I would consider to be not sexually attractive, what they're doing, I mean, you know, it's fine. People have done that for a generation.
Sometimes my question here on this is, narratively, why did we need the beginning? Like, why did we?
Well, because he has a job.
It would show that he's a man who lives one life, and then when he's at home, he's in heaven.
So this is why that manager who you don't like, just feel free to just be like, you know, just, I don't know, just be mean to them.
All I know is that, honestly,
or don't be mean to them.
You've sometimes eaten, sometimes every once in a while, like if you're going to go down on a woman,
they just happen to be on the toilet.
There might be a little bit of pee on there, right? You know, it kind of gets in there. You do whatever you got to do, right?
Whatever. Yeah, of course. You have anything what women go through?
But also going straight to the fucking vagina after she's peeing. That's married.
That's love. That's love. So I'm actually come full circle. I think what they've done is fantastic. It's beautiful. Cleanest fucking bathroom I've ever seen.
I mean, I don't know.
And you know how long that would take. The human tongue is not that long.
The smell of a tongue-clean bathroom, though, can't be great.
You might have to clean. You might have to wipe it after.
You do. Maybe do a little saliva, clean. Dried saliva smells
but
terrible.
But I am actually very... Yeah. Now that I think about some humorous bits, these Mr. Clean... Mr. Clean...
I
love that Mr.
Is
Clean
a
commercial. I didn't. They failed to mention that he cleans everything, including your wife, with his tongue.
You know, hey, if you invite him in your home, it's like a vampire.
Absolutely,
it's like Robert.
But I do recommend watching the rest of that documentary the basement. No, because they give the same treatment to every subject. You know, they a guy coming home in his like regular shitty
this
car.
This woman is a dominatrix to many people.
This is just one story in an anthology of stuff that happens in Austrian basements.
Oh,
but there is one man who is he's got his members only jacket. He comes home in a shitty little car and he like polishes his saxophone. And then we go down to his basement, wall to wall Nazi memorabilia.
Oh,
statue of Hitler in there, his most prized possession. And then his friends come over, they're all wearing lederhosen, and they practice Nazi marching songs while his wife is upstairs doing dishes.
Yeah!
So it's like,
I don't.
The secret lives of Austrians, it's worth a watch.
Because also in the basement, truly, that's where you got to keep your Nazi memorabilia.
Yeah.
Because if we get into this country, that's the whole thing.
Part of a window.
Yeah, that's
some
not like the Christmas
do.
Story leg lamp. You don't want that just sort of brightly shining out of your front window.
There was just a story about a man with a swastika flag, and then someone went over to steal it, and then they shot him. Because believe it or not, these people with swastika flags have a lot of anger.
Yeah, there's something about
the
swastika.
Like, the guy wasn't like, it's a Buddhist symbol. The guy was like, it's a Nazi symbol.
Yeah, that's the thing. Is that because like I actually almost, do you appreciate people that say it's a hardcore Nazi swastika versus the people that say it's actually Buddhist for good luck?
Who's worse? It's definitely not good luck. So I think maybe the Buddhists were wrong about that one. I think that's when the Nazis won the branding war over the swastika.
Well, let's quickly go into this next video. You guys have been talking about rats and gerbils and hamsters and whatnot. And it sent me back to a scene of a show that I think we all know. And I just wanted to show that on the stream for all the youngins there. So
that's
let's,
great.
Let's watch this scene.
Kids got to learn.
Be under complete domination. You must be pleased with that.
Well, let's just say that it pleases me to serve our leader with whatever minor talents I possess.
John told me that our leader's very pleased with your conversion process.
Yes, but MacGyver. You know how impatient our leader
MacGyver?
Can be.
Mm-hmm. You?
Yep, it's MacGyver.
I thought that given the intimacy of your relationship with him, he might...
Be very careful, Stephen.
I just hate to see him make you so distressed.
Doesn't understand that my conversion process is still limited. Doesn't work the same on every human subject.
No, but when it does work, as with Davidie, Jankowski, and the others, it's remarkable.
Yes, it is.
They actually believe that a conspiracy exists, or even that they're part of it.
And, of course, the evidence that we planted reinforces their beliefs.
The operation is working perfectly. Scientists are being ostracized, disorganized throughout the world.
The problem is, our leader then says, why not convert them all? He doesn't understand that the human will is much, much tougher than we bargained for. To convert them all would take forever.
It's really not
However,
true. Humans can be broken.
We will continue to refine the process.
Yeah, we do it with commercials. Successfully.
Is he eating it? Oh my
God. Yes! No, this is a MacGyver?
That's not a meal. I don't think this is MacGyver. Let me see if she can put that big hamster in her mouth.
Chosen anyone who could do a better job than you.
That's why I put it in my downstairs mouth. Yeah, take it! Take it! Yes! Yes!
Oh my God! She throated that thing right. Look at it going down.
Oh, I love her.
Wow. Wait,
so when the fuck did MacGyver fight Alien?
I don't think this is MacGyver.
This is not MacGyver.
That's not MacGyver?
No! It's just another dude.
I thought you were
from the 80s.
I thought you were doing like a, oh, this is Miami Vice.
I thought that
something.
Was, this whole time I thought that was Richard Dean Anderson.
Yeah, me too.
No, that's V. This is V.
Oh.
That's powerful. Why didn't he, he doesn't need a gun though. He should have had a little camera so he could have recorded all of that because the gun doesn't remember.
Was that Richard Dean Anderson, though?
No, I don't think so.
No, I think that was just a Richard Dean Anderson type.
To be so lucky.
Type, maybe Don Johnson? Yeah. Don Johnson? There was a type in the 80s, the 80s male, what was considered sexual.
Honestly, I think that they are still considered sexual. I think there's most people, honestly, I imagine on this chat, would fucking definitely throw down for MacGyver if gotten a chance, and definitely probably have blown several MacGyver types.
Well, the nice thing is if you date MacGyver, you don't need birth control because he's going to figure out a way to get out of that baby.
Oh,
he'll
my God.
He'll take like toothpicks, a candy corn, who knows what he'll use.
Mike, MacGyver, he's fucking you. He goes, oh, I'm a fucking cum, I'm a cum, and then comes, and you're like, oh, no, don't come inside. Like all my favorite movies, right? No, don't you come inside, you meek baby. And then he goes and he's just like, I got a way to do it. And he gets some gum and a paper clip and kind of sticks it up there and he wipes it all up.
Yeah, I mean, if that works, it works. MacGyver, fantastic. I wonder whatever happened to him. He's fine, though. I think he solved all the cases he could and then he just retired.
He does stuff.
Well, they rebooted it several times.
Yeah, he's back.
I loved MacGyver growing up. I loved it.
I want to say he's on TV now as MacGyver.
Dude, I think
MacGyver
Ben is Schwartz back. Is maybe MacGyver.
Honestly, it might be.
There
it
are so
be.
Many actors that are super successful. I'm like, what happened to that guy? And they're like, oh, he's been on TV for 30 years. I'm like, okay, good for him.
Wow. He's got his own website that looks like it's from 1999, but like a really nice 1999 website.
That's all he needs. He doesn't have to change it.
It's a headshot of him from, looks like 1988 right at the top.
Perfect.
But he does actually share and do blog posts about his dogs.
That's huge. It's so nice. There are a lot of people saying that they would fuck him, but more people are saying Tom Selleck.
And
they said that guy, and that was the guy who played Beastmaster.
Oh, yes. Beastmaster. Great movie.
Uh-huh.
Very fun.
All right. Well, let's move on to this next video. This is I have to stress because I did some digging. I was like, is this real?
Okay.
I cannot tell if this is real or not because it looks so much like a Murder Fist sketch.
Okay.
So this is a real news segment from New Zealand from like 2008. So let's just let it play. This is real.
This is real. Okay. Travis Morningstar did this rack research.
It is National Hoodie Day, and it seems for every supporter of the day, there is a detractor. One company politician went to the extreme, donning a Ku Klux Klan costume at a council meeting. Dale Evans wore a white outfit with a sign around his neck mimicking the slogan used in the current National Hoodie campaign. He's outraged the deputy mayor, perhaps not surprisingly, who said it was appalling to use a serious episode of racism in American history as an analogy to the hoodie campaign. She declined to appear on the program, but it hasn't been hard to find others somewhat offended by Evans' actions. Canterbury American Studies lecturer Dr. Vernon Andrews has called Evans' statement ignorant. Dale Evans and Dr. Vernon Andrews join me now. Good evening to you both.
No
Good
way.
Evening,
Dale, what were you thinking when you put that outfit on and went into the council meeting?
Political satire to get the message across regarding the boil water issues and nothing else. It was not meant on any racial issues, and it's to highlight the importance of certain things that need to be addressed.
How can you imagine that it wouldn't highlight racial issues?
Well, basically, that is
no. This is hoodie. This is literally
you have
like
to do
sweater.
Some extreme things to get them out in the open, and it was not.
You also got like the
view,
nicest Klansman
to be
outfit I've ever seen.
To anybody. I don't have any racial
it's what's under
prejudice
the hood
about any, but
that
a lot of my friends are
colored.
Oh, and, you know, basically it was just to get the issue out there.
People, Vernon, say that, don't they, in situations like this? Some of my best friends are colored.
Right, and that sometimes just to deflect away maybe from their own ignorance. And first of all, I just want to say, personally, it just hurt to see something like that in New Zealand. Because one of the reasons I'm in this country is because of the high levels of tolerance of others. And again, New Zealand does have its issues and its problems here and there, but I've seen a large amount of tolerance in New Zealand. And so something like this kind of brings me back into reality that even New Zealand can have these difficulties every now and then.
Sure. I was going to say to you, Dale, do you regret what you've done? But given the costume that you're wearing on nationwide television tonight, I guess the answer is no, you don't.
No, I don't, because basically when you look at all the issues with regards to wearing a hoodie and the circumstances with regards to they've been banned in malls, the police and surveillance cameras, they can't see who is under the hoodie, and in banks and all this issue. Now, you know, I think there'd be a better way of promoting Hoodie Day or possibly in another way or in another issues with getting the message across.
Dale,
and
can we see under your hood? Can you lift your hood now?
If you wouldn't mind. Oh, yeah, of course I am. I've got no worry. Thank you.
Oh, my
well, I'm sure people
God.
Are
oh my fucking What
I'm
the
not surprised
fuck?
By what
oh
they now see. You seem
God.
To have blacked
oh
your face.
Oh, my God. This is the same guy who
well,
says the swastika
is
a good
I
luck
have
symbol.
No racial discrimination about anybody. Everybody's equal in this world.
Why would you
it's
have
so
done
It's so scary.
Why have you done
that? Well, political satire to get the issue across. Because that's, you know, sometimes you have to
it
do
It is so scary.
You're on TV.
And this is turning down.
And I like how they're all calmly just being like, yep, well, all right. Let's go look at it.
So, Hoodie Day.
It's under the, because he also specifically says it's under the hood that counts. And then he's in blackface where he's just being like, that is wild.
What happened to Dale Evans,
so
the politician?
He had to make a huge apology in all of, like, the New Zealand papers. And
did he
resigned.
Oh, did he have
he
to
did,
make
yeah.
an apology?
But he really does have, like, I read it before today's show, and he actually says, you know what? I know this is crazy. I did not realize how insensitive that was. I actually did not see.
That might be part of the problem.
They're, like, such a remote little, you know, island. I wonder if his brain really didn't put two and two together.
They
like,
have
so
the
this
internet.
Is, this is
he's
vile.
He's putting the makeup on. He's putting his costume on. He'd be like, I'm nailing
this
it.
This is satire.
This is going to be very good.
This is satire.
Jesus, you're right, man. It's better than any sketch you could ever create because it was real. So that's that almost breaks comedy.
I
that
will actually say, humor. I think that that's what he kind of, because he's so misguided and he's a moron, I think that he honestly thought that if he took it off, they'd laugh. And then when he takes it off and then he's just like,
been there.
That look, the crushing silence of them looking at him must be so wonderful. I wish I was in the news studio, because the news studio, I guess it's like they can't even laugh at it because they would have to be like,
I just feel
like, can we keep this? Can we keep the cameras rolling?
I feel bad for the other guy that said yes to the interview, like the point counterpoint. He's like, what the fuck am I doing here, dude? This is crazy. All right, well, New Zealand, God, they're just like us.
They are.
Isn't that nice?
Dude, he barely, like, he looked more like he barely looked like a clan member. He looked like he was dressed up as like the wizard from the first Final Fantasy.
Yeah, seriously.
And he was so
he's a white mage.
He put on such a dark layer there that was really reminding me of like The Conjuring or something. He seemed like something you would see in the next life.
Oh my god!
Horrified. All right, so that was very interesting. I'm surprised that's not more popular. I haven't seen that before.
I had like as I was coming to the studio, I was like, oh my god, it's fake. Like I shot back to the moment where he takes the hood off and I'm like, oh, this is a sketch. Like this has to be a sketch, right? And I looked it up and I was like, fucking, this is sure enough. This is a real, this is a Murder Fist sketch come to life.
Wow. Holy shit. Well, you know.
Oh man.
I guess he resigned and then he moved on to his letters.
I have no
like,
idea.
What do you do after this?
Talk about an unforced political error. Just don't dress like a Klansman while wearing blackface.
He went on to write Joanna Man. So it's actually had a successful arc.
He brought it back around.
Yeah,
and unseen, he helps society with laughter.
Good for him.
Speaking
absolutely.
Of helping society, Elon Musk. Let's watch this video of Elon.
He's not the worst.
Epilepsy warning.
Okay.
Epilepsy
if
warning.
You have epilepsy, check out this video.
Cover your eyes. Yeah. If you want to extra check this out.
I used to think Bill Gates was one of the good ones.
He's not.
Seems like
not. No, he's another. Anybody, you lose a human characteristic.
All right, welcome
when you become
to
a million.
The Neuralink product demo. I'm really excited to show you what we've got. I think it's gonna blow your mind. So I want to emphasize the purpose of Neuralink. Like, what's our goal? Our goal is to solve important spine and brain problems with a seamlessly implanted device.
This is
and
how he
this
sees
is
himself.
Sort of what it looks like.
Oh,
this
cool.
is that little device.
Neuralink.
I mean, frankly, to sort of simplify this, it's more complicated
this
than this,
was
but
his
it's,
SNL
in a lot of ways, it's kind of like
spot.
A Fitbit in your skull with tiny wires. So does it actually work? And what I'm excited to show you, I'll call it like the little pigs demo. Yeah. All right, cool. So you want the surgery to be as automated and as possible, and the installation of a link done in under an hour.
Good brain.
So you can basically go in the morning and leave the hospital in the afternoon, and it can be done without.
Swipe it in there.
I want this to be real, though.
The invented the headaches. Oh shit!
Yes, I want this.
I did like that one movie. What was it, Upload or something like that? They can take the duct tape off at this point.
This actually seems pretty sweet.
It's miserable.
Let's imagine for a few moments what our life would be like if we could access, let's say, 20% of our brain's capacity.
Isn't that a myth?
Yeah. Oh.
Yes, kill him!
Oh, it's a socialist
yes!
robot. That also created you, didn't it, socialist robot?
Yeah, that's what happens. Capitalism made you, but then you destroy capitalism.
Oh my god, now he becomes
a
billionaire.
Oh, it's fucking
it. The analogy continues.
It does.
I could see Elon Musk dressing like that for sex play with Grimes.
Well, Grimes is... she can't have too much leather because I imagine her skin is actually very irritatable.
I love them. I think they're a cute couple. Weird.
They're fine.
Okay, well, thank you for
thank
making
you
it,
for,
Amen.
Thank you, Amon.
Amon indeed. And what a man Elon Musk is.
But I don't mind. I want to do the Neuralink. I want to get it all
no,
set
you
up.
Don't.
But he's just, the
it's
problem is
not going to work out.
It might.
We are the test dummies. For like 300 years from now, they'll be taking out like vitamins. But we can't because then it'll be horrible. We're kind of like on the cusp of like cool, but we're not quite there.
No. Two generations after us will get the really, really cool shit. But yeah, we're just going to get the hanky, like that sort of stuff that can maybe give us like a couple of extra years. But it's going to be some real bad fucked up.
Who are we testing the Neuralink on?
Honestly, I just watched something on this about this fella named Gleason, who was a player for the New Orleans Saints. He blocked a kick and he got Lou Gehrig's disease, but he's still alive. And he really has just become a brain in a machine.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I mean, not really, but in his body is very thin because obviously he has no muscle mass anymore. But that they're doing that stuff.
Oh, they're certain. But I just like wonder
Lou
Gehrig's,
but you don't want to be on the test subject because then you have to get Lou Gehrig's.
Well, sometimes but the military guys also get a lot of the very experimental.
And they don't come back scarred or traumatized. But when they come back from the war, they're so happy.
They have those cool new hands now.
Yeah.
That is true. But then you also see the people who cut off parts of their body to try to get it, but then they realize they don't have the health insurance for it. They just lost an arm for nothing. I don't know if any of that's true, but
I think it'd be sweet to have one of those, because those new hands, because I sometimes have hand problems. I wonder where it's from.
I have no idea.
Because this is the hand I use.
I hate you.
It's this one.
Yes, you were just touching
it
with that.
Yeah, it's fine. I've washed.
It's so gross.
Semen's alive, so it runs away.
No,
it does squiggle away.
I don't know if that's true.
Is that true? Like, honestly, though, does not semen not, like, run away? Does it have to be in the pool of liquid? Or
no,
can
it stays
the actual...
in the pool of liquid.
Yeah, it stays, like, if it, like, kind of runs down your hand, then it's technically running away,
but it's
not going to actually
viscous liquid.
Pop out of the semen. It's not, the sperm is not going to pop out, because the semen and the sperm are two different things. The sperm is contained within the semen, so when you scoot your semen all over your own hand and it runs down, sperm's just going to stay in the semen. It's not going to hop out and, you know, go
get it.
That's
what I was always afraid of, is that it could jump.
That's like that's venom.
Well, it's like sea monkeys.
That's
like
sea monkeys.
They got to be moisturized.
All right, cool.
Yeah.
Let's go on to this next video.
Just asking questions. Just learning about all this type of shit.
I get
America's
it.
Got Talent. Have you guys seen this? Maybe this might be one of those big viral ones, but let's watch this.
Wow. According to Dustin Black, after coming back from Afghanistan, they made us all go through some sort of light-based therapy at least once. It was strange.
Okay.
I wonder what that means.
Very nice.
So this guy on America's Got Talent, his name is Ivan, the urban action figure.
Okay.
So let's see what his talent is.
Okay.
Biggest moment of my life.
One second.
Right now. 3 minutes.
Jerry Springer.
Okay, now we're ready. All right, here we go. Everybody.
I don't even know what's more nerve-wracking, being a judge or being up there.
Okay. Action figure. Okay. All right.
Let's begin.
Is that meant to happen?
Is he winding us up?
Was that supposed to happen?
Let me get through, please. Ivan.
I don't know if it was scripted, but they are thankful.
This is so Jerry Springer, too. He's just like, yeah, I've seen this before.
You breathing?
Oh. He died. Is he dead?
He is.
This was not supposed to happen.
Yeah, obviously not.
The question is whether or not he landed on his head.
Thank you, Jerry. Can I get a moment of
thought? It's not part of the act.
Can you step aside, people?
Give us some room, guys. Give us some room.
It's cool. Guys always lay really still like that when everything's fine.
How did he die?
Still, I don't
he just
him.
Smashed his head. He just was bad
what
at it.
What was he supposed to do?
Jump over the chairs.
This is a horrible moment.
And he tripped on the first one.
Yeah, he's not responding. Let's see if we can get an ambulance on the scene.
America's Got Talent, baby.
Wow, that's America's Got Talent.
That was on national television?
That was on that. Yeah, that's very much like your wrestling bit with...
What's the guy's name again?
Ivan the Urban Action Figure. I don't think he died. I think he got seriously injured. I don't know.
Yeah. This is 2020, right? Or something like
he just knocked himself out.
Oh, that's fine.
He went to the hospital.
He deserves it.
Yeah, he received medical attention afterwards, but his audition was canceled and there was no time for him to try again. They were going to give him a second try.
At best, he would have jumped over chairs.
You gotta give him another try. Honestly, I don't know how they didn't bring him back every week to see how much other things he could jump over.
I don't think he can jump over things. That's the problem.
He's supposed to do a front flip over, and then he kind of just like basically does the robot. But that's like his urban action figure thing, is that he's like all of his joints are popping and stuff.
He split his
fucking head open.
I see. Okay, not part of the...
What did you get, Marcus?
He's now expanded his activities into the fitness industry with Ivan's Dance Rock, an entrepreneurial adventure which merges his passion for performing arts and lifestyle fitness.
Okay, well, good for him. All right, I think we have time for one more video.
Let's do this. You know, speaking of the Black Death episodes.
Yes.
Genghis Khan.
Genghis. Thank you.
Whatever.
Thank you.
Came into play.
It's Dan Carlin. I don't know. I'm just trying.
Dan Carlin is also like sometimes like, can you just leave me alone?
So, I don't want to deal with the hardcore history army.
I know.
No.
But so, do you guys remember the show called Deadliest Warrior? It's where they would pit a different type of fighter throughout the ages.
I do remember now.
Against each other. Like one of them was the Taliban versus the IRA.
They chose like a it's like a samurai versus a 1930s gangster.
Yeah.
And they're like, he has the Tommy gun, so he has the advantage. But the samurai is built to beat young John Dillinger. And they go to fight him.
But they
My favorite was the Wild West gunslinger versus the Aztec warrior.
But so they had an episode that was Hannibal, the general, versus Genghis Khan.
Okay.
So I tried to find that. So I thought that'd be a fun thing to go out on. I couldn't find the actual clip, except for this video starring, I think his name is Lord Reptile Stormblade. It's him watching that episode. So we're going to watch that clip with Lord Reptile Stormblade.
Yeah, I'll
do it. They did with Ancient Aliens, when they canceled Ancient Aliens, and we just had to watch that one fat dude talk about it.
Tsoukalos, Giorgio Tsoukalos.
No, not that guy.
So let's watch with Lord Reptile.
Welcome back, my loyal subjects. And for this next battle... It was created for the show Deadliest Warrior.
Okay.
We have Hannibal, the general from Carthage that defeated the Roman Empire way back.
Okay.
Against Genghis Khan. Okay. A very brilliant Mongolian warlord.
Okay. Oh my god.
Simply
this
since
is like the kid, this Hannibal, is like the kid from Malcolm in the Middle.
Defeated Rome.
He's
going
to get
to
the
video. To have to root
action
brought
himself in now.
Oh, good for him. I have nothing wrong with him.
Anyhow,
Walker, don't you dare insult me that way.
Without further ado, let's see. What's at least two wonderful warlords? We'll win.
Wonderful warlords. Is that the right term? Yeah, this
totally
show was
very
so
different.
Good. This is what Jeffrey Toobin looked like when he was jerking off.
God, it's so comforting to see him back. Nature's healing.
I'm so happy.
We keep forgetting to bring him up. He's just staring at it. So this is his response video. He's just looking at it. He's just looking at the footage.
Does he know that he's on?
He's right there with us watching this. These two incredible warlords.
He's telling the story with his eyes.
Yeah, he's nodding.
Well, he's on Hannibal's side. You might have missed that. He's betting on Hannibal.
He is betting on Hannibal. Okay.
Why would you ever bet on Hannibal? Of course I'd bet on Genghis Khan.
Of course. Definitely. He's making the wrong choice. Oh,
ah. This is what Twitch is, though. You know,
is what Twitch is.
Well,
it
usually
is just,
they talk.
You talk over it a little bit.
Technically, we're just a microcosm of him.
Y'all do. We descend from Lord Reptile.
We do.
We really do.
We do.
Now it's us commenting on him watching Deadliest Warrior.
The armor.
Yep.
Ding. He's just staring at it.
Genghis Khan is just going to win this fight already.
He has to win it.
There you go. Slice him.
Jesus fucking Christ.
I can't believe this guy went with Hannibal. What a moron.
This guy is probably in the chat, Frank Reynolds.
Could be. Good job.
Well, that didn't go as expected. Winner is Genghis Khan.
Didn't go.
Hey,
wow.
Honestly, that's
it. I wanted to save the most explosive video for last. But we do. We're getting out of here. But here's a music video. This is a compilation of all the deaths from the show 1,000 Ways to Die.
Oh yeah,
but
like
set
that
to Nine Inch Nails. So we'll just go out on this video.
That's great.
There was surprisingly amount of people who wrote on this show.
It really were a lot of people who wrote on that.
Bye everyone.
It's a lot of there's a lot of comedy writers who wrote 1,000 Ways to
Die.
Oh
yes, it's action. Yeah. I actually loved this show.
Oh,
I
love.
I was kind of a sucker for it.
We'll be back here next week, next Monday, doing the same shit.
Oh, thanks for everyone who came out to Red Rocks. We had a great time.
Yeah, it was fucking amazing. It's a dream come true. Thank you.
Oh, in a dog bowl!
Yes! That's one of the 1,000 ways you can die.
They're kind of stretching it a little bit with that.
They do.
I used to think these graphics were a lot better. Bye, everybody.
Bye.